honestly already really truly dreading the comments from the so-called experts on this video. It's like walking on very, very thin ice. Today, there's another slightly different video because I want to test something again. Yes, I'll call it a hype from the USA that I've seen on several different larger American YouTube channels. And what they show there, I somehow can't quite believe. It's about pouring concrete, specifically dry concrete. You heard that right, as you might have guessed. I'll show you a little more clips from the video initially. And as you can clearly see, I didn't promise too much. The couple seems to be building a foundation for the shed entrance and is using completely dry and hard concrete. It looks like a formulated ready-mix concrete. And I have to admit, when I first saw the video, I was a bit shocked, right? What is your first impression when you see the way they work here for the first time? I would be interested to know that too. I've seen this in several videos. And it's always presented in a way that you don't need a concrete mixer, it saves a huge amount of time, and most importantly, that the concrete hardens and is just as durable as normally poured concrete. So, as you can tell, I have my serious doubts about that. I'm open to being convinced otherwise, and you can only have an informed opinion if you've tried it yourself. We're going to start a test and we'll know. Let's get started. We're doing the test in my brother's garden. He has a spot where he hasn't laid any grass yet, and I've already set up a small formwork for my foundation. Of course, this isn't a particularly elaborate formwork, that's clear. I just screwed a few more boards together, fixed it on the sides with some supports to give it some stability, and that's all we obviously need, a bit. Of course, our ground here is not suitable for a proper foundation, that's clear. For a foundation, you need a frostproof structure, which we obviously don't have here, but for our test, it doesn't matter. Not that people think this is a tutorial on how to make a foundation. It certainly is not. And our foundation here will be removed again. Before I started with the concreting process, I first carefully and thoroughly watered the ground so that it can later effectively transfer its moisture to the dry concrete from below. Anyone who has ever worked with concrete knows that the cement it contains practically attracts moisture. You can notice this. If you leave a bag of cement open, it will absorb moisture from the air and harden in the bag. So, for example, let's start with the concreting. We will use regular concrete screed, such as the one commonly used in construction. So, let's pour. I'm curious. I followed the same steps as in the video. I put the dry concrete into the formwork, filling it all the way to the top. For me, that's 8 centimeters, and I think the height is somewhat identical. So, I would say, roughly estimated, the formwork in the video is also about 8 to 10 centimeters. So the test conditions are roughly identical. I then compacted the concrete screed a bit, because it will be removed later anyway, and then I filled the formwork up to the top edge. Yes, I chose the size of my formwork so that 2 bags of concrete screed would fit in, because I didn't want to waste too much concrete for the test. Pointless, of course, in quotes. After that, I smoothed the surface with a board just like in the video. That worked quite well, and then the surface already looked pretty good, 2001. But of course, it wasn't completely smooth yet. But the two Americans in their video had a solution for that as well. They simply took a paint roller, rolled the surface completely, and afterwards the result was indeed very smooth. So I was actually a bit surprised at how extremely well it worked. Yes, that looks pretty good so far. The surface is nice and smooth, and now we just need to water the whole thing. And that's what we'll do next. For the first watering, I adjusted the garden hose so that only a very fine mist comes out at the front. You definitely can't go full force here, because otherwise the dry concrete will be completely washed away, creating huge holes in the surface, and then you'll end up with a very uneven surface later on. This can be significantly avoided. All right, folks. After this absolutely incredible masterpiece of concrete work that I've just laid down right here, I'll grab a beer, and then in approximately 2 hours or so, we'll continue with another second round of watering. Cheers. So, here I am again. 2 hours have passed, second round. After 2 hours, the concrete has already started to set slightly, so you can water it a bit more intensively now, and it won't wash everything off the surface right away. The second round is also done. I'll do the whole thing again this evening, again in about 2 hours, and then we'll look at the result tomorrow and also do a load test. A little more than 24 hours have passed. It rained a bit overnight and earlier as well, which is obviously good for the concrete, but it does skew my test results a bit. Oh well, never mind. Now let's see what the concrete has done overnight and how the slab looks. Here you can see the result, and yes, the surface is at least definitely hard. It's not entirely smooth, but for a foundation, it's still absolutely okay. Then we'll increase the load a bit more, significantly. So far, everything is still solid, but 90 kilos is a huge load. But at least, I have decided that we will do the final stress test in 2 to 3 days. I will destroy the foundation with the proposal, and then we will see what concrete looks like from inside. Because that's really the interesting part. You guys will continue. I have to wait a little longer. See you soon. After 3 days, I started stripping with great anticipation and excitement, but then quickly realized that something was still not quite right. Although the surface was actually hard and looked quite dry, it looked a bit different inside, that is, below the shell. Well, it had also rained a lot, and the wood barks, the water 2001, and the moisture. This is what the stripped foundation looks like now. I had to go a bit overboard with the stripping because I couldn't reach the lower screws anymore. And as you can see, it tore off the corners here. Yeah, that's not so great. No, I probably stripped it way too early. The concrete is still moist and crumbly. It hasn't set properly yet. It takes significantly longer than with liquid concrete. We have to wait a bit longer for the stress test. It doesn't make sense yet. We have to wait again. But what can you do? All right, folks, it's been 6 days since I poured the concrete. Now I want to find out. We're doing the stress test now, so let's see. For that, I need a tool that can effectively assist me in a variety of ways for instructions. I think we will definitely have more success with this. Yes, so the foundation has withstood more stress than expected. But if you look at the concrete on top, it is still quite moist. It was clear from the beginning that the foundation would crack because it has no reinforcement. But now let's take a look at how the chunks look inside. It is already evenly moist, so there are no dry spots as one might have actually expected. In fact, I think it might have just needed a few more days, especially since it has been raining quite a lot lately. Yes, but the test was still interesting. I didn't expect 2001 like that, really. I then tore down and removed the foundation. In doing so, I found that the lower layers were significantly harder cured than the upper ones. This was another insight I gained from my experiment. Yeah, folks, my conclusion about the approach with the dry concrete is, to be honest, a bit mixed. The positive aspects at first glance are that you obviously don't need a mixer, you are faster in terms of time, and the work is also easier. And of course, when pouring, you naturally have more time because the concrete only starts to cure when water is added. This is all correct, and I can confirm this through my own experiment. But what I am not convinced of is that the foundation is as durable and resilient as a foundation that is properly poured. It starts with the fact that the curing took forever and still wasn't complete. Normally, with regular concrete, it doesn't take that long to reach at least a certain level of load-bearing capacity. Next, I have to say I showed you the surface, which was quite porous. In winter, moisture can penetrate, and if it freezes, it can cause damage. So as I said, regarding the load-bearing capacity and durability, I have serious concerns. Many of you have them. Of course, I don't know where the Americans in the video are from. If you live somewhere in the United States, particularly in Florida or California, then frost is naturally not an issue at all, but here it is. What honestly surprised me a bit during the test, and what I didn't expect, is that the concrete was so evenly saturated with moisture. Well, I actually expected to find arid gravel pockets inside, but that was not the case at all. I also noticed this indeed when stripping the foundation. Well, maybe there are some of you out there who have poured concrete dry and can share your personal, valuable, long-term experiences. I would be interested, and I think viewers would find it interesting. So if you have any experiences, write them in the comments below. With that, we are done with the topic.
Next, we will build something cool and it will be delicate. More details will not be revealed. And if you enjoyed the video today, give it a thumbs up. Thanks for watching. Take care. Bye.